quiet. Shh, shh. It's oh so still. Shh, shh. You're all alone. Shh, shh. And so peaceful until you fall in love. Zing, boom. The sky up above. Zing, boom. It's caving in. You've never been so nuts about a guy. You wanna laugh, you wanna cry, you cross your heart.
All right, the problem has existed since 2002.
CF standards, absolutely no doubt, is one of the sort of prime causes of complaints from football fans that are not allowed to stand while watching their team in the top two divisions in English football.
I'm told as well that, you know, there is research which suggests that, you know, people are more likely to become injured if they're standing rather than in a stable position when they're seated.
I proposed a motion that said that basically that where clubs wanted to, they should be allowed to bring back safe standing.
We need to alert fans, alert visiting football fans, to not just to the dangers. Hopefully that they'll take on board the effect that it's their fellow fans, you know, those aged fans, the smaller statured fans, those who aren't able to stand for 90 minutes, children who are precluded from travelling with visiting fans because they aren't going to be able to see if everyone stands.
Everyone who goes to a game knows that if you speak to the crowd, the vast majority of people will back the option to stand, and a good percentage of those will actually want to stand. We just need to get it through to the heads of the politicians, to the administrators in the places like the FA, the Football League, the Premier League, and also the journalists, more and more of whom are starting to listen to supporters as well.
I think what's important to stress is, you know, whilst the grounds are required through football rules, regulations and legislation to have seated areas and no standing areas, you know, that's what we will police do, and that's what we would need the police do. Our whole requirement here, you know, is to make sure that people come to football and have a safe and enjoyable afternoon.
Well, my own standing as the party's spokesman on these matters is perhaps less important than the fact that the whole of the party supports me. It's what fans want. It would get more fans into the ground, and it would get rid of some of the real problems we have in the all-seater stadiums at the moment, where fans are actually standing on the seats, which is highly dangerous, and yet the stewards and the police are unable to do anything about it because so many fans are doing it. So what we've got at the moment isn't particularly safe. Fans want something that's different. They want the opportunity of safe standing, and it's now perfectly possible with clear evidence that it can work and be safe. So we want clubs to have the opportunity to be able to do it if they want to do it.
In 1994, the Lord Justice Taylor report recommended the introduction of all-seater stadia in England. This was on the back of several disasters that had occurred under the old terrace model. Currently, it is against ground regulations in the top two tiers of English football to provide a standing alternative. This has resulted in fans breaking the rules by standing in front of their seat for the entire game. In Germany, fans are offered the choice of a safe standing area. This is a safely engineered space designed to easily house tens of thousands of fans, allowing cheaper tickets and a livelier atmosphere. Claims have been made about the safety of fans persistently standing, resulting in punishments ranging from seat allocation cuts to fans being thrown out during a match. The debate is currently occurring in Parliament, following a bill to be introduced to advocate the safe standing model in England.
At Valley Parade, the whole end of the stand at one side is actually in flames now. I can see the orange of the flames, and people are running around. They're running around beside us, they're running around all around us, and people are saying, get onto that pitch, keep the electrics over there, keep them, take their time, don't rush, don't push, watch for the kiddies, the smoke coming everywhere. We are going to have to disconnect very shortly because it really is craving all the time. We're taking a break, we're getting out of it.
We have chaos with fans on the field, I'm afraid to say. The Liverpool end there, either people have got in with forged tickets, or perhaps there too many tickets have been printed. Perhaps there's been a problem with the gates or the turnstiles at that end, but there are too many people in the Liverpool end of the ground, and that's the top and bottom of it.
Obviously the 1980s was a dark time for British football. You had the Bradford fire disaster, which was absolute tragedy. where Standard Bradford City Court Fair. There was also Hazel, where in Liverpool and Juventus in Cup Final, sort of an incident in the crowd led many fans down. There was also the most, probably the most well-known of all, which was Hillsborough, where 96 Liverpool supporters lost their lives.
Well, Hazel, Bradford Fire and Hillsborough were all examples of where we had the old standing arrangements that, frankly, were totally unsafe.
The fallacy is that Hillsborough was caused by standing. No, it wasn't. Hillsborough was caused, it was obviously an awful, awful, awful tragedy. It was caused by fences, poor policing, and poor stadium architecture. Even in the Taylor report, which came out following Hillsborough, nowhere in that did he blame standing for the events that occurred.
All of the research evidence that took place after those incidents demonstrated that the arrangements were unsafe. And it's not surprising that the inquiry that followed by the late Lord Justice Taylor came to a conclusion that we needed to move for the top flight football games to all-seater stadium.
It's now into the 22nd year since Hillsborough. And the really good thing, if anything good can come from a disaster, was that the report by Lord Justice Taylor and his 76 recommendations into the incident that occurred at Hillsborough, we've now gone 22 years with Touchwood without any major incident occurring at football, which is the longest post-Second World War period that we've experienced, you know, without having some major disaster or catastrophe occur.
What are the legal issues, if any, of fans standing at football grounds?
Right. Well, in terms of actually committing specific offences, they don't just by standing in itself commit an offence in law. What they do is they commit offences or commit breaches of ground regulations. We don't have a power to actually arrest somebody for standing if that's all they're doing. We don't. What we will do is we will support, as we do with both grounds, we'll support the club in their safety operations. So if, for example, a club steward is seeking to get somebody to sit down and that club steward decides that actually that person's not going to sit down and they're then going to invoke some sort of action in relation to breach of ground regs, we'll support them in doing that, but that wouldn't result in an arrest unless there were some other offences then displayed.
Football supporters are not allowed to stand at matches, and again, there's other examples, rugby league fans are, people going to music concerts are. There's absolutely no doubt football fans are actually discriminated against in law. And there's also all sorts of institutional attitudes towards football fans, where there's that sort of softer discrimination about maybe the way people are a bit harshly policed or overzealously sort of treated by stewards and things like that, that maybe isn't set up in statute. But there's no doubt that if you're a football fan, you've been to an away game, you know that you're treated like other members of society just aren't.
I don't think discrimination is the right word. I think that what you will find is that after every disaster such as this, or Hillsborough or Ibrox or whatever, there will be an inquiry. And there will be some findings that come from that inquiry. I think the key bit, or the key part of any inquiry, is that we learn from it.
For 3 years, the Championship will allow you to have standing areas until, in their eyes, you bring the stadium up to standard, up to scratch, and you have it seating.
And clearly that has been the effect of Lord Justice Taylor's report, that, you know, that did result in the conditioning of the Football Spectators Act in 1985, which essentially conditions and makes a requirement of law, the requirement for clubs within the Premier and the Championship to be all seated.
Now, Scunthorpe will be entering their fourth year in the Championship, therefore it dictates that they have to then bring in standing. Now, they'll lose about 1,000 places in that ground, so that's a lot of lost income for them. People getting locked out. It's a very small ground. Scunthorpe will take it from about 9,000 to 8,000. So people feel really strongly about it. And it's just a ridiculous concept that you can have it for 3 years. It's safe for three, but not in a fourth. Well, if it's that unsafe, surely it shouldn't be allowed at all. You know what I mean? We argue it is safe anyway. And the concept that Premier League and Championship clubs aren't allowed standing areas, but League One or League Two clubs are allowed standing areas, is a bit weird in itself, that the quality of football on the pitch dictates whether it is or isn't safe to stand in a terrace. It's just a really crazy idea, isn't it? It just doesn't make any sense to me.
What I want and what the Liberal Democrats want is to have a system of safe standing that provides what people want, that gets more people into the ground, can enable us to have somewhat cheaper tickets so that real fans have an opportunity to see their heroes. I think it's perfectly doable. And as a result of that, I've already been in correspondence with the sports minister, Hugh Robertson, urging him to take action on this front. And we're in the middle of correspondence about that issue. And I know that he is not averse to looking at this if he is satisfied that we can do it in a way that is safe.
Polls regularly show 9 out of 10 fans would like the option to choose whether or not to stand. It's something that benefits both people who want to stand, for obvious reasons, but also people who would rather sit in a match, because at the end of the day, if you're maybe older or you're younger or you just don't feel like standing, there's nothing worse than me sitting down and someone standing in front of you, so it benefits everyone.
Safe standing, an arrangement whereby every fan who stands has got his or her own allocated space, has got a rail in front of them and behind them, and has somewhere to sit down if they need a rest or at half-time and so on. The evidence and the existence of such an arrangement simply wasn't there at the time, but now we have examples from around the world that show that it can be done, that it is safe, it delivers what the fans want, it can bring prices down, and I see absolutely no reason why we don't give clubs who wish to do it, subject to very clear safety regulations, the opportunity to introduce something that fans are desperately keen to have.
If the legislation were to change, and it then became acceptable that grounds could have areas that were safe standing areas, and I go back to what I said earlier, yes, you can develop and build safe standing areas. If the law were to change, then equally, we would lend support to clubs to advise on how best to do that.
You know, whilst we have the regulations and the requirements that we have presently, that's what we need to work to. If in the future there is these designated designated standing areas, well, so be it, and we would then have to adjust our response accordingly. But as it is at the moment, we all know what the conditions and the requirements are.
I think it would be a big step for football to take to return to the terraced areas. But again, you know, as an employee of the City Council and responsible for the certifying of the football club, if the legislation did change and the club decided that they would like to return to a terraced area, we would give 100% full support to, you know, what the requirements of the law were saying.
But I'm reasonably optimistic that with the pressure that's coming from fans, the pressure that's coming from politicians, the pressure that's coming from a number of other bodies, then I think that the government are going to be forced to look very seriously at it. I know that they're beginning to. I'm going to keep up the pressure. I hope everybody else will do the same.
You blow a fuse, zing, boom, the devil cuts loose, zing.